Hey everyone, welcome to another Salesforce admin tutorial video. In today's video, I'm going to talk about conditionally required fields and how we can achieve that behavior in Salesforce. Now, as you may remember from my previous videos, I have developed this Lightning app, which does not exist. It's only for video purposes. This is called Speedy Sales, and this Lightning app has two custom objects in it, purchase orders and speedy products. Great. Right, so in purchase orders, let's take a look at the page layout. We have our order number, which is an automatically generated number by the system. We have some other data fields such as order description, quantity, and so on. From the previous video, you will remember that we had worked on date and date time fields with default values in them with formulas. Right, so in today's video, we will work on a conditionally required field. So when we select order type vendor order, we would like to make vendor name a mandatory field. So if I select vendor order, I should not be able to save this purchase order without inputting a value in vendor name data field. At this moment, this is possible. So let's create a purchase order. So my order without vendor name. Okay, so I'll just leave this empty, although I have selected vendor order here. Save. Okay, so my purchase order was created. Perfect, because we have absolutely no conditionally required field configuration in the system. So let's go to our setup and configuration page. Now, if you log into Salesforce and you're not taken immediately to this page, remember you can click on the gear icon here and then click on setup, and you will be taken to the setup and configuration. Great. So let's click on Object Manager and then navigate to the Purchase Order object. Okay, this is my Purchase Order object. I click on this. So you will see that I have all my data fields ready. Vendor name is here as well with this technical API name. So this is the unique name, unique identifier of this data field in the system. Right, so what I'm going to do is I will write a validation rule in order to achieve the conditional required behavior. Right, so let's create a new validation rule. We need to give this rule a name. So let's say conditionally required vendor name. You may give this a description as well. Conditionally required field vendor name. And you can even describe this further when order type equals, I guess it was vendor order. Okay, great. Now, here in this section, we need to write our formula. This formula is actually going to achieve the entire behavior. So let's start typing our formula. And so let's insert our field, which is order type. Okay. However, I can't just put it like this. I can't just type equals, what was the value again? Vendor order. Let me just copy from here so I don't make any copy and paste mistakes. So this is not going to work because this is a pick list, but I'll show you that it doesn't work. So the logic here is that this data field, when this data field equals vendor order, I cannot have a blank vendor name field. All right. So the second condition is on the vendor name. Okay, so how do I say that this is blank? So this we will achieve by simply using the isBlank function. Okay? So the only problem is here. So you will see that my formula will not work because this is a pick list. So let's try it this way. Oops, apologies. All right, so let's try it this way. Okay, so you can see that with the correct function, our syntax is now correct. So the first condition is, you can see here, if my pick list order type C value equals vendor order and the vendor name is blank, I need to throw an error message to the user. Okay, so this will not let, this validation rule will not let the user go any further as long as these conditions are correct. So I am going to throw an error message with this validation rule is when order type is vendor order, please fill in the following field, vendor name. Okay, this is quite explicit, right? So when order type is vendor order, please fill in the following field, vendor name. Perfect. So do I want to display this error message on the top of the page? No, not really, because this is relative to a single and specific data field. So this is exactly where I will display it, which is the order type. Because the order type equals vendor order. Or you may want to display it right below the vendor name, because this is the data field that you want the user to fill in. So it depends on how you would like to instruct your users. Let's leave it at vendor name. All right. So again, you see that here in our formula, we have two conditions. The first one is vendor order. This is the very first condition. And then the second is that this field is left blank. So let's save this validation rule. So remember, as soon as you save the validation rule, it becomes active. Okay, so it's not going to wait for another automation or anything like that in the system. So if I go here now, and if I try to create yet, okay, let's just refresh the page anyway. And then if I try to create a new purchase order, say, this is a vendor order, and then select vendor order quantity and say this is North America, and then save. All right, so there you go. We have our error message here saying that when order type is vendor order, please fill in the following field. So you see, the location of your error is right below the data field that you specified in your validation rule. So it depends on your instructions. All right. So if I type just anything at all, anything, A, I will be able to save this purchase order because the rule is only checking if this data field is blank. As long as it's not blank, this validation rule will not kick in, all right? So say, okay, my vendor, any value really, and save. So what about the previous order that I had created? This one. Let's see what happens if I try to save this again. There you go. So it's going to apply to any order actually, even the existing ones where I had left vendor name empty. I will not be able to edit and try to save it again. But as long as it's there and nobody tries to edit, the system will just let it live. Okay, it's going to exist with a blank vendor name because this validation rule, you wrote this validation rule after creating this record, but you will no longer be able to edit and save this without a value in the vendor name. Okay, so create rule. All right, there you go. So just to recap, what we did is we navigated to our object, which is purchase order. Then we created a new validation rule with two conditions. The first one is when my order type is vendor order, and then at the same time, vendor name field is blank. It's empty. There's no value in it. And then I wrote an error message and I placed this in the following location, which is right below vendor name data field. And again, as long as this is active, it will kick in immediately. All right, guys, so you can take this rule actually and extrapolate and add new values at new data fields and add additional conditions, not just this, but also other conditions on top of these, and adapt to your specific needs. All right, I hope this video has been useful. Thank you very much for watching and see you in another Salesforce tutorial.